So we learned a ton of new information this episode, so I'm going to get right into it. Now, within these organizations that try to manage the divide, we're starting to learn that there's different agencies within them, and those agencies have different priorities. So there's management, there's strategy, which Howard, Prime, and Aldrich are a part of, and then the new agency we learned about is diplomacy. So Baldwin has been captured and is being held by police, and strategy, they want to interrogate her because what they care most about is information for security concerns and keeping the peace. Diplomacy, on the other hand, what they love is they love having these situations where one side is something the other side wants, so they can use this and exploit it to get information from the other side, not about security things, but about just general scientific knowledge, for instance. And we learn that since the Prime side has this huge pandemic that decimated their population and they're still recovering from that, they also learned a lot about disease, vaccines, the human body, and also it seems like GMOs and certain aspects of food production. And at one point in the negotiation, Lombard, the ambassador, he says, "I can give you the census reports, but only up to 2011. That highly implies that it's shortly after 2011, which would imply this is current times. And since they were battling their way back from extinction for the last 20, 30 years, they haven't been able to focus on technology. So they haven't been able to develop things like cell phones. It's very different than them having developed cell phones. Then this big catastrophe happened and they lost the technology they already had." And the people involved in diplomacy, they believe that the benefits that can be gained potentially from getting information and knowledge from the other side far outweigh the potential dangers of having people that can cross over and the dangers that come with that. And you can see why, because if they could negotiate a deal where the one side would give the technology to develop cell phones and the knowledge to the other side, and the other side would give all this vaccine and maybe almost end diseases, that could be so beneficial to both sides. But you see how hard it is to set that up, and it's just constant work, this little back and forth give and take to try to set up these exchanges, because there's no trust, probably from the pandemic, which one side believes the other side caused. And we learn a bit more about Peter Quayle. Now, he is Howard's old boss, maybe still current boss, but that's kind of nebulous. He's British, looks a bit like John Oliver, and we find out that he is dating or married to this guy named Roland. Now, it wasn't mentioned in the episode, but I looked it up. Now, he is a high-up guy in diplomacy, and so he's Peter's father-in-law, but we also find out that Peter cheats on his wife or spouse or girlfriend with prostitutes. And the person managing these negotiations for the Prime side is Claude Lombard. Now, he's interesting because he's the ambassador for the Prime side to the other side. And what that means is, even though he's from the Prime side, he actually lives on the other side at this place called the embassy. Now, he seems like somewhat of a prisoner at this embassy, where if he wants to go anywhere, even just to go out to eat, he has to get a written request. So it seems like he almost spends his entire life just living at this embassy as this point of contact. Now, this Lombard character, he also has the power to revoke visas of people from the Prime side to be able to travel to the side that he lives on. So he says to Howard Prime, "Look, this was your fuck up that Baldwin got captured and someone on the side got killed, so I'm going to revoke your visa." Now, what Howard does in response to this is he thinks Lombard is a double agent kind of working with Baldwin. So he says, "Look, I want to continue to stay here on the side to spy on Lombard. Howard, not Howard Prime, you go back in my place, because if they know that no Howard went back to the other side, they're going to know something's up. So look, you go back, you pretend to be me and go back to the other side. That'll allow me to stay here and continue to spy on Lombard, eventually get my visa privileges back as well." And now, while these negotiations between diplomacy are going on, Aldrich uses his connections with the police to take normal Howard and go try to interrogate Baldwin. They're not really able to. Before they're able to get the information, diplomacy reaches a deal, so they're tasked with taking Baldwin back to the other side. While they're transporting Baldwin back to the other side, their car gets opened fired on. It's really unclear why, because they're trying to rescue Baldwin, the people who shoot the car. So either they know the bullets aren't going to do any damage, and then why are they firing them? Or if they think the bullets could kill people, why are they just firing into this car? It's not really clear. But anyways, they rescue Baldwin, and we see the mask pulled off, and we realize it's Claire, and she's another double agent, very important, who rescues Baldwin. Okay, now we get to Emily's storyline, and that's the most interesting. Now, I can call her Emily Burton versus Emily Silk, who is Coma Emily, because she divorced Howard, so she doesn't have the last name of Silk anymore. So Emily Burton, she meets with this guy. We don't know his name, but I'll put a photo up. Now, she gets the authorization codes for who authorized this rendition on Howard Prime. She realizes it's Alexander Pope. Now, Emily Burton's lover is Ian Shaw. That's his name. And he reminds me so much. There's this famous actor, Chiwetel Ejiofor. I'll put his name spelled in the description. You can look it up. Total similar vibe. Now, what's interesting is that we find out why Emily Burton and Howard Prime broke up. Now, they broke up because Emily Burton had a secret that she didn't tell Howard about, but Howard Prime about, but Howard Prime found out. What's very interesting is we realize that Coma Emily, Emily Silk, she had the same secret about Howard, but she didn't tell him and he never found out. That's one of the differences between the two realities. And what's interesting is, did Howard Prime finding out about the secret change his life in this way? And is that what made him so different than normal Howard? And is that what sent him on to be the way he is, so aggressive and stuff? Or was that change already happening before? And that's one of the reasons he found out, was because he was different. So did he find out and that made him different, or was he different and that's why he found out? Anyways, Howard Prime tells her, hey, can you go to the church and put a flower on, I think it's his mother's little vigil. And she's like, sure. When she goes there, she finds a letter. And in this letter, she finds out that Howard Prime and Howard's and Emily Silk, other Howard's Emily, they've been communicating this whole time, and she's been passing him information, and that's how he's getting information about the other side, Howard Prime. So, and we also find out that it's most likely that's the reason that she got hit by a car and is now in a coma, because whoever didn't want them passing this information back and forth, they found out and they took her out. Emily Silk, in her letter, asked Howard Prime, please take care of my Howard if anything happens to me. Now, what's unclear is everything we've seen Howard Prime doing, is that him taking care of Howard, or is that just what he is doing anyways, regardless of the wishes of Emily Silk? And then at the end of the episode, it looks like Emily Burton is killed. Now we get to questions. I'm not quite sure. At the end, the person who seems to be the murderer of Emily Burton pulls something from the phone. Doesn't really look like a phone bug, but I'm not sure what that was. Now, another question, can people from the non-prime side cross into the prime side? Now, we've seen people from the prime side cross into the other side all the time. To my knowledge, never seen someone from the non-prime side cross. Now, is there a reason for this, or is this just a coincidence that we've yet to see it, but it can happen? Now, there are also two names we get that I'm not sure what they are. We got Midnight Station and Section 2. I don't know what either of those things mean. Also, some of the things that they were asking for during the negotiations, either I'm not sure why they were asking for it, or I'm not sure how they would know that this is important. So when they asked for the census reports, is that just so they have an idea of the population of the other side, so they know for military strategy whether a war would be feasible? I don't know why the census reports would be that useful. I mean, information is power, I guess. And also when he says, look, we want the locations of these oil deposits, how would they know that the other side knows about these deposits that they don't know about? Very confusing. Okay, I'm going to end it there. Last thing I'll say, we know now how characters, at least on the show, refer to their doppelganger. They call them their other. And as always, if there's anything I missed, anything else you want me to clear up or talk about in more detail next video, leave a comment and I'll definitely respond to it.